You're at 8900 E Jefferson F, Detroit, Michigan.
Partly to mostly cloudy. matters a lot tonight. The far-right group accused of conspiracy and of using this choreographed military stack formation to get past the police lines and to get past the doors. We'll also hear the name Proud Boys a lot tonight.
Former Homeland Security Secretary Jay Johnson tells CBS News it's time for graphic images of those killed by semi-automatic weapons to be released to show the impact of gun violence.
I do not advocate for the disclosure of any specific image, but I do believe that Americans need to see a much more vivid picture of what an assault weapon can do to a child's body.
In Uvalde, Texas, where 21 were killed at school last month, Superintendent Hal Harrell says people are trying to move ahead.
Our district will continue to provide counseling support for our staff, families, for the foreseeable future. Currently in our summer programs, we have counseling support available for all students on the respective summer school campuses.
The Justice Department's opening an investigation into the Louisiana State Police amid evidence the agency has looked the other way in the face of beatings of mostly black men. CBS's Cammy McCormick's got the latest on a deadly military aircraft crash.
Four of the five Marines on this Osprey were killed. It went down yesterday in a remote area more than 100 miles from San Diego. The Marines were based at Camp Pendleton. This is an aircraft that takes off and lands vertically like a helicopter, but flies like a plane.
The fifth Marine is unaccounted for. PGA says golfers who play in the rival Saudi League will no longer be eligible for PGA events. Nathan Murphy of the Golf Weekly podcast says it's a big money battle.
The money is out of this world. Certainly it is the greatest price and rival that the PGA Tour has ever faced.
Phil Mickelson and Dustin Johnson are among those playing in the inaugural events. The White House now says it has a plan to deliver 10 million doses of COVID vaccine for kids under 5 by June 20th. Approval by regulators expected next week. Infectious disease expert Dr. William Schaffner.
This is exciting news to pediatricians, family doctors, and many parents because they want to bring their youngest children in to get protected also.
Right now the Dow is down 115 points. This is CBS News.
This hour's newscast is presented by Rocket Mortgage. When you need cash out of your home and a simple way to get it, Rocket can. Live and local. Number one news team, News Radio 950 WWJ.
Good afternoon. I'm Brooke Allen. Our top story.
Breaking news now on WWJ.
Leading candidate for governor arrested by the FBI. WWJ's Jonathan Carlson just off the phone with federal agents. He is now live with new details. Jonathan.
Yeah, Brooke, I'm told this investigation will likely expand. GOP gubernatorial candidate Ryan Kelly was arrested at his Allendale Township home this morning. He's been charged with a misdemeanor for his participation in the January 6th insurrection at the Capitol. But I'm told there were multiple warrants, meaning agents were searching for additional evidence regarding the case beyond that misdemeanor charge. I'm also told he will appear in federal court in Grand Rapids this afternoon. He is likely still in custody. I also spoke with his campaign within the hour. They had no comment. The timing of this comes as tonight televised hearings into that insurrection are set to begin on Capitol Hill. So again, we could be learning more as we go through the charging documents in this case. And as we get more details, we will, of course, bring it to you. Reporting live, I'm Jonathan Carlson, WWJ News Radio 950.
For more, let's bring in WWJ legal analyst Charlie Langton. Charlie, we are hearing that this arrest is for a misdemeanor. How common is it for someone to be arrested by the FBI for a misdemeanor charge?
It's very uncommon to be arrested for a misdemeanor. It is rare. But it's also a misdemeanor that happened in Washington, D.C. is also rare. Now, procedurally, Ryan Kelly will appear before likely a federal magistrate in Grand Rapids, as Jonathan Carlson just explained. He'll be read his exact charge. We know it's a misdemeanor. We don't know exactly the charge. But then likely a personal bond will be set. However, since the charge of the crime allegedly happened in Washington, D.C., assuming that is the case, he'll be given a date to appear, likely, in a Washington, D.C. federal courtroom. And that's where the crime will happen. Now, politically interesting, Ryan Kelly will stay on the August ballot. Now, perhaps some of his supporters may not like the fact that he's being charged by the feds. Others, however, may use this to charge up his campaign and rally his supporters. We'll have to see.
Hey Charlie, a number of Michigan residents have been arrested for their alleged roles on January 6th. What type of charges have we been seeing?
I've been
report stamped at every station to win a prize. It's on June 11th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at Livonia's police and fire stations. Visit LivoniaPassportToSafety.org.
Every time it rains, you start feeling it again. Is my basement going to flood? Will my house be damaged? Will it make me sick? Is there anybody who can help? There is. Free mental health counselors are available online for a person to help you move past the disaster. One flooded basement can leave trauma for years, but there is help to make the sun come out again. Call toll-free 1-888-874-1819 or visit crisiscounseling.care.
Real estate.
Down about 25 points. We will check your money at 1225. WWJ News Time, 1223. It is time for sports from your Metro Detroit Chevy Dealer Sports Desk. And here's Chris Ballard.
And a Michigan State Beach finalist for a five-star quarterback in C.J. Carr. He's going to make a decision on where he'll play his college ball after his time at Saline High School. Carr is the grandson of former U of M head football coach Lloyd Carr. And also has Notre Dame on his list of possible destinations. The current quarterback of Michigan, Cade McNamara, speaking with the Conquering Heroes podcast with John Jansen to discuss his preparations with the team this offseason and what he needs to work on.
Taking even more of a leadership role. Yeah, I mean, we lost some big leaders last year, and I think, you know, it's my job now to fuel our guys to really help leadership even more and help other guys get that train pushing in the right direction.
Getting their second day off this week today, the Tigers will prepare for a 10-game homestand, including this weekend's series against Toronto. Rodriguez, Bo Prisky, and Derek Scoobal. With sports, 23:53 past each hour, Chris Bavar, WBJ News Radio 950.
Radio.com is now Odyssey. Download the Odyssey app and listen to WBJ News Radio 950. Get all the news, sports, music, and podcasts that move you. Powered by Golly Auto Group. Experience the Golly difference at Golly.com. June is Men's Health Month. I'm Dr. Adam Kipinski of MHP's Comprehensive Urology.
Worst color to have, brown, which depreciated nearly 18% in just
which lost just 4.5%,